guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to World Trade Center, Abu Dhabi, the souk. In Arab countries, souk refers to an open-air market, a place where people can buy and sell goods. Abu Dhabi's central market is one of the oldest sites in the city, inspired by the traditional architecture of the Gulf, offering an alternative to the globalized one-size-fits-all shopping mall. It combines luxury goods, boutiques with food markets and craft-based trades, like the traditional souk.
So here I am in search of the restaurant that my friend suggested.
So I was told that it's straight and then
right.
Hi, I'm good.
Such a sweet, warm welcome. He's more excited than I am to be at this place. I thought I had arrived early and I can take some videos before I get in. And I was taking my own time, but as you can see, that pink top over there, I believe that's my friend. So I went around walking and taking some videos for the vlog. Also, I was a bit confused about where exactly the entrance is. But I'll enter and wait for her. And to my surprise, as you can see, that's her walking towards me. She was already there waiting since like 10-15 minutes. So we got inside, sat down, and there is a QR code to scan for the menu. I will show you guys around before the food is served. And this here is their tea bar. A trendy cafe concept from Amsterdam Teas, which serves some of the best teas, coffees, and desserts. The Botanic Atrium Food Hall emphasizes high-end restaurant experience with the choice of a diverse food hall. The food hall features some exquisite brands which has Thai, fusion Chinese, sushi, cafe serving teas, coffees, cakes, and they even have option for Korean biryani. In other words, you will be spoiled for choice. I don't know, we'll get it.
Don't do this, okay? It will spoil.
Oh, okay. Thank you. 5 minutes. Oh, so cute. Hello. And it's more in the press, I think. This is so cute.
Where are the marks?
Oh yeah, but it's okay. I think because we asked for this, maybe that doesn't count. So I was wrong. The strawberries are supposed to be added and they missed it. We actually got it at the end after we paid the bill. They brought the strawberries and apologized saying that the staff missed out on the strawberries. Sorry about that. We were like, it's okay. But yeah, those were like frozen strawberries. We had it separately. I'll show you the video I had taken of it. My friend had got fruity iced tea called Lychee Lady, and mine was strawberry karkade or karkadi. It's pronounced in different ways on YouTube, but basically it is the Arabic word for hibiscus. You have to wait for about 5 minutes. This is the tea timer. I had a really good time just watching this happen. I used to have these Agla sand timers when I was little, and I used to love just watching it. Just time flying by, passing by, being in the moment. Here though, I'm talking to my friend in the background, which I will be muting because let me hear it first, okay, and then I'll edit it out accordingly. Just a second. So here our starters have arrived. This is Chinese dumpling, and we have pad thai here, and I absolutely love the dumpling. Pad thai not as much, but the dumplings were too yummy. The presentation was pretty impressive. So here I'm instructing my friend as to how to take the video.
Okay. So guys, 5 minutes we had to wait before we would have
cut. Before we do this, we shouldn't pour like this because it's hot. So we have to basically... Oh, that's amazing.
We
Nishi and I know each other since college days. It's been a really long time. We were not in the same class, but we were in the same college hostel. I used to have this habit of going around making friends from different rooms. And I used to go to Nishi's room too, and I had other friends in her room. And I used to go there just to relax and just chill and talk with them. So calming. They were so welcoming all the time. I used to just go there. Even when they're studying, I'll just go there and sit and do my own thing. They'll be doing their thing. They'll just let me be. And I remember clearly when I was leaving. So basically, I was moving to a PG outside, and my friends were engineering students. They still had a lot of years to settle in. I had moved in the second year itself because I'm a media student and project work, and also I wanted to stay outside. And while I was leaving, Nishi and her friends had got me this gift. It was so sweet of them to get me this while I was leaving, because I used to be a frequent visitor, like, in their room. Don't remember exactly what it is now, even Nishi doesn't remember it, but I remember that gesture. I remember feeling so nice back then, but I still haven't forgotten. And Nishi is still that sweet person who does sweet gestures. I had such a nice time, like the old days. And coincidentally, Nishi got married to another close friend of mine. And she happens to stay just 5 minutes away from my place. And yet, after all these years, finally we are meeting in Abu Dhabi. And I'm so happy, and I hope there are more of such meetings. And to end the day on a sweeter note, we have the mango sticky rice here. It looks delicious, and it has been presented so well, and it tasted yummy. I would definitely recommend the mango sticky rice and the dim sums from here. Absolutely amazing.